Hey everybody, Boston here. Let's play some more Binding of Isaac Afterbirth. You can ignore this run we've got going on. I actually lost my save file, and I had to do some steam cloud related magic to get this back. In celebration, I kind of want to just do an Eden run. I was thinking about just doing an Isaac run, but. Alright, so our seed is H2AQ VPDC. It looks like we have Diplopia and Poison Tear? No. I don't remember what that one is. What is our damage? Pretty okay. So our health starts out alright. Our damage is okay. We have a fairly alright looking run. Alright, let's get rid of that fly first. So I don't know when we want to use Diplopia here. I really cannot afford to take damage like that. You almost want to save it for something really crazy, like a really great boss rush, or a if you go down to the chest, a really good set of items in that first room, but. You know, if we get something like a Cat of Nine Tails or something like that, what do we need to do? Just Mega Satan. Quote unquote, just Mega Noob. Oh no, this is terrible. Also have not seen that room before. You know, if we can save it for something like that, that would be pretty useful. Ooh. I guess you can also save it for a really good deal with the devil, and I believe that picking the items up when you Diplopia them and they show up on the doubled up ones show up on the pedestals, they don't cost any hearts to pick up, if I remember. Ooh, but I never see Diplopia that much, so we'll have to. We'll have to wait for the right time to strike here. And Mom's Heals is definitely not the right time to strike. Okay. So this is kind of the fun of Eden runs that I really like, where it's... Well, I've never just had Mom's Heals, I don't think, where it changes your sprite to have heals on. That's probably not worth it. Sorry, I'm a little distracted. One of my cats, Tybalt, back here is trying to figure out what he's doing. A lot more damage would be pretty nice. I'm kiting these guys pretty well at this point, but just need to do a little bit more. Let's open this first before we use that. All stats up. That's pretty great. So you could have Diplopia'd that. But I'm not sure that would be the best use of it. I guess you'd get, you know, two stats up, which would probably be pretty okay, but I don't know. You could make a case for it. I'm sort of thinking like, well, would it really be worth it to get two stats up? But the thing about Capricorn is it increases all of your stats, so, you know, I'd get two hearts, I'd get twice the speed, twice the damage, and tears, and all that, so, I don't know, maybe. Let's try and find our shop here. I have 7 coins, so I'm hoping something is on sale, maybe. Try to look out for some tinted rocks. Whoop, as I walk right into the wall because I'm looking for tinted rocks. I was actually just thinking, oh, maybe I should use the Empress on this room, but I can just kite these guys and it should be okay. Well. Alright. I'm hoping my sound is alright, actually, now that I'm thinking about it. My settings got all messed up because I had to uninstall and reinstall Binding of Isaac to fix my lost save games. Yeah, let's try this. Broken watch is not really what I need right now. I definitely need that. I probably need that, which is good. I'm gonna pop another couple cents in here. So I talked about this on a daily run here. Probably, when will this go up? Probably about a week ago or so. Where I fired up my Binding of Isaac just to see how many more challenges I had. And my save games were gone. Just completely randomly. Still have no idea how it happened. Still a little bit worried about it overall. What do we have here? Larry Jr. And I've spent probably the last 2 days here trying to figure out how to get everything back. I managed to get everything back here, thankfully, because... So I talked about it in that daily video, but might as well chatter about it a little bit here, too, just in case anyone else runs into this. Yeah. Meat is good. Just in life and in general. This is good, and I can afford to take the health. So damage is pretty good. So if you go to your stats screen on one of your save files, if you have lost your save, you can actually bring your save back up to the point where to match your Steam achievements. If you hit Alt F2, it'll actually... Oh, jeez. sure, Lucky Rock is okay. It'll actually bring... It won't have a record of things you've picked up, and it won't keep a list of... Oh, okay. It won't keep a list of, sorry. I'm trying to figure out what my cat is doing. I'm recording really early, so I'm a little scatterbrained here. It also won't keep your donation machines or your greed machine, which is really why I was... You just saw my donation machine, so I didn't want to lose... Come on. I didn't want to lose that. So I opted to... I actually had to delete my game and then manually... upload and kind of rename and scoot around my save file between... Ooh, I can't do that. Between my local machine and the Steam's local cache of your Steam Cloud saves. So, thankfully I got it back. I'm going to be a lot more paranoid about backing up my save files here for probably quite a while. Let's go in here. Well, little Chubby's not great. Let's use Hangman to start getting some of this stuff and opening some of these chests up. I can open up both of those. Have I been to the item room yet? No. So I'll open up... Well, I definitely need that one. Let's just open up both of them. Cool. I was hoping I would cut even on keys here. Alright, so we definitely have enough money. There we go. Alright, I can't fly anymore. That was just a card. Cool. Broken watch again? Really? So we definitely need that. I'll pick this up. Why not? And let's put more money in here. I think there's an unlock at 800. So we might as well get pretty close there. No tinted rocks in here. Usually is on a room that looks like this. Anything else? Not really. Not really worth it for, to wander around the rest of this floor. Little Chubby does some pretty okay damage here. Ah, good. Just Spider Pestilence. He should drop a Spirit Heart anyway. Oh, he didn't. I don't really want either one of those. The Fear Shot, I'm maybe not playing at my best here, so I don't really want to tempt the fates by starting to fear enemies. I have a real hard time fighting enemies that are feared because they start just moving so strangely and erratically. We will definitely pick up this piece of guppy. Normally I would keep it around with me. Oof. Because I like the extra damage from the flies, but gotta keep that Diplopia. I feel like Diplopia, even though I haven't seen it a ton, oh, this is Champion Haunt. Ooh. I kind of have the same problem with it that I do the D6, where I just don't want to. I don't want to give it up, because it's clearly right around the corner. There has to be something really good that I can use it for. Let's try Secret Room here. Nope. Alright. Really wish I could fly for rooms like this. But maybe. We've started the, started down the old Guppy Trail. So hopefully we can get Guppy. That would... I have a high enough tier rate that Guppy would be pretty powerful at this point. Yeah, let's just try it. Alright, so Whore of Babylon is kind of the natural choice here. I don't really want... I mean, I want Gimpy, but ugh, that sucks. So I'm doing a ton more damage now. Come on. Oh, yeah, jeez. Champion Belt is pretty good, so is... I might actually Diplopia here. Yeah, because I kind of want both of those. Alright, let's see if we can get to 800 now. Nothing. Alright, let's Diplopia here. So I can get that. I can take that. And take that. And that. And now we can go back to our... Got all that stuff for free. Which increases my damage quite a bit. And ooh, that's not where I was looking to go. So I want to go back and get Guppy's head here. But let's do the item room here real quick. Might actually donate a bunch of that. Spider Butt isn't really that great, but I'll take it until we go get Guppy's head. Which is down here. Take that. Alright, that's probably not the most optimal way to use Diplopia, but you know, being able to mitigate curses and getting Champion Belt, which is gonna increase my damage by quite a bit. What was my damage? Yeah, it's at 5 now, so I think that was kind of worth it. Again, I'm sure we're going to run into something in about, you know, on the next floor where it's going to be like, I should have kept Diplopia. But, you know, could always say tomorrow, tomorrow, tomorrow. But I got today. Yeah, we're going to donate some of this. This room kind of stinks. Yeah, Lucky Rock is actually working out pretty nicely right now. I think I can make bridges with these guys, yeah. Let's get this stuff. Just so I can get more money. I was hoping for Magic Mushroom. What floor am I on? Catacombs 2. So I'm not doing super well on the boss rush front. But I'm doing a ton of damage now, so let's see. Actually, I can pick up another one of those? That didn't increase my... damage all that much. Just dump as much money as we can in here. Alright. Pick another one of those. I think this will be another hermit. Yeah. Unless I should just use hermit. Oh. Well. That's fine. I always get hermit and the moon confused. No. Nah, not worth it. This, however. Okay, let's be able to walk around corners here. There we go. Alright, my damage is in a pretty nice spot now. So just really need to keep an eye on my health. Yeah, I like that. Like that quite a bit. Wretched is pretty great with the amount of damage that I have. Make short work of that guy. Yes, safety pin is also really good. Great. The amount of evil slash sin items that I have right now, picking up picking up a black feather would actually be pretty nice. Two bombs for three keys and a gold chest is probably going to be a pretty good trade. Especially so I can get ahead of the keeper. Yeah, let's try it. Why not? Let's go crazy on this run. So as always with Head of the Keeper, if you have some light sensitivity and flashing sensitivity issues, you might want to look away slash stop watching. These things, especially if I pick up a lump of coal, these things are pretty nasty. So I'm probably going to be okay with for money on this run, which is pretty nice. Definitely have enough keys to find our... Yeah, just getting keys from everywhere now. Definitely have enough keys to find the item room. And I have a hermit card, so I'll probably use that for the shop once I have a little bit more money. Figured this was going to be worth it. Looks like it. Health up, which, oh, I don't want because of Horror of Babylon. Crap. Use that. One makes you small. Great. I should have used Hermit there just to get out of that room for free. Oh well. That took care of that problem for me. Okay. Whoop. Perfect. I'll save the Hermit card then. No sense in using it right now. Boy, getting a ton of consumables now. Yeah. Five does the floor back over. Alright, so let's go find our item room and our shop. Pick up those items and then maybe even do the boss and then start the room back, or start the floor back over. This is going to be probably a pretty long run here, but we're starting to see some seams we can rip open here. Alright, so we've got our item room, or our shop. Portable slot isn't really what I want. Let's see what this guy is, the fool. I'd rather keep the Hermit card. Alright, so we have our boss. Let's go knock out our boss real quick, and then we can go find our item room, and then go in the five dice room. Monstro 2. Not so bad. Doing enough damage here that Monstro 2 is kind of famously super tanky, so it's a good indication of how much damage you're doing overall here. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. Alright, like one, there we go. Alright, definitely get coat hanger. Fight Krampus, so I'm hoping if we do this floor again, we won't have to fight Krampus again. I would like Lump of Coal, probably be the only thing I want here. Cool. Alright, so again, I will say, you know, if you have light sensitivity issues, it's probably not the episode for you to watch. Because these things in combination with, Tinted Rock, in combination with Lump of Coal, is a real bad time. Well, there's really only one place the item room can be. So let's hoof it back on over here. Do do do. Do 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 do. Hey, there it is. Right under my nose the whole time. Alright. Get that. Tears up and knockback shot. Cool. At this rate, cancer would be a really nice pickup. Mostly so I can break the tier limit. Yeah. Alright, let's hit this 5 here. Start this guy back over. It's just like Forget Me Not, or Forget Me Now. Just taking a little drink there. Alright, so I don't have Horror of Babylon anymore. Let's use Hermit. I mean, I have to get Chaos. There's no other option. Justice, let's use Justice over here. Endless Nameless, which I... Oh god, it's making a bad problem worse. Endless Nameless, I'm gonna keep that because I think it is... When you use a consumable, I think it has a chance of dropping an identical consumable right next to you. So it's like you didn't use one. Alright, so I need to find a blood machine, so I'll keep an eye out here for the, an arcade. Just so I can get back into Horror of Babylon. Oh, here's a marked rock. Tinted, sorry. This is probably a secret room. Perfect. Well, that is interesting. Alright, so I found the... I already went to the shop, so we're really just looking for the item room here. We already found the boss. Let's try the trap room. Yeah, why not? I'm doing enough damage. Juice's tongue probably isn't what I need. It's an item that I really never pick up. All it does is, when you get a deal with the devil that takes... that would take 2 hearts, it decreases it to 1 heart. And I think once you pick that deal with the devil up, it disappears. So, a pretty specific type of item. I was gonna stay safe in that room and not pick up the coin there. Really want to keep my health, except for that one red heart I'm trying to get rid of. Even without Horror of Babylon, I'm doing quite a bit of damage here. All right, try and stay away from all of these red hearts. Oh, this room sucks. Oh, that was so close. Whew. Yeah, I have so many keys, we might as well open it. Curved Horn is really great. What's my... yeah. So Curved Horn is, just right out of hand, it's a +2 damage. So, really never a bad time to pick that up, I think... okay, that room is totally empty. I think if I find cancer, I'll still probably keep that. I guess they were trapped there because of those spikes. That's interesting. So I'll probably still take cancer. Oh, I'm not gonna pick up missing, no. I don't think I have it in my item list, but I'm having such a great run at the moment that I don't really feel like jeopardizing it with missing, no. There are a lot of runs where it is fun, but maybe not the right choice right now. Yeah, hoping that would help me out a little bit there, but I don't think you can. I don't think Hematemesis can bring you down to half heart or 0 hearts for that matter. Really hoping for an arcade here. A little late, but that's alright. You never know when you're going to be able to use it.
Hmm.
My voice is already getting a little raw here. Jeez, it's only my second video of the day. And maybe it's my last. Alright, no arcade on this floor, but that's alright. Those things are pretty plentiful. Alright, adversary doing a ton of damage. This is so nice. Oof. Come on, there we go. Fanny pack is alright. Not really what I'm looking for when I pick up chaos, but it's not a bad item, so can't really complain too much. The sun. Actually, I'm gonna hold on to that excuse me, for a minute, just in case I get blank card in my shop. There is an unlock when you use blank card sun. So I'm going to try and make that happen. Because that one is pretty annoying otherwise. That felt pretty good. Another sun. Okay, so I'm just going to use that. Just so I can get the whole floor here. Alright. Sure. See what craziness comes out of this thing. Nothing too crazy. Plenty of money, man. Yara. I'm not gonna... We'll keep an eye out for something we can use Yara with. Alright, we have another, one of these guys. What do we have in here? Music on this floor is super loud. I think mostly because my speakers are up. Yep. That's alright. Just a bunch more consumables. I like it. Ooh. Get them, flies. Yeah, play more flies. Remote detonator is not good. I mean, it's not bad, but it's definitely not anything I'm going to be jumping for joy over right now. Do that again. Oop, shop was up that way. Take care of that red fire. Alright, come on, some good. Ceremonial robes is pretty good. Oh, right, I'm full on health. Man, if only a donation machine hadn't jammed already. Let's pick up that. What is this? Health up, which I definitely don't need at this point. Trying to go the opposite way. No arcade on this floor either. That was close. Yeah, let's blow up that guy to try and get a better chance at a deal with the devil. Oops. Alright. Hoglaws, Tagaz, Tagaz, Yara, Awaz. Awaz. Alright, still gonna keep the sun. You never know what could happen. Definitely running way too long to come anywhere close to boss rush, but that's alright, because this is now an interesting chaos run. Need to do Mega Satan, but I really think the only way I'm gonna do that is if I get Dad's Key. I've already done Dark Room. Let's do a chest run. I have enough keys, and I have chaos, so that could potentially make any chests I open in there a little crazy. I'm just looking to make this run as weird as possible. Ooh, okay. Still pretty happy with my damage. Oh, also getting myself into a corner, again. You know, the Boston way. No. It's two different colored health up pills. Come on, video game. Now it just seems like you're doing it on purpose. Alright, so I'm not getting a ton of pickups here, so I don't think I'm really running the risk of breakfasting myself. I don't really need that. Sure, why not? Could get a golden chest or a red chest that pops out from doing this. So it's worth taking just a little bit of time to do this. Probably not going to run into Hush either, which is fine. I'm doing a lot of damage, but I kind of just don't feel like fighting Hush. I would like to roll into those first couple rooms with Chaos, but there's no real way to bounce out of fighting Hush once you get down there. Alright, as usual, I'm continuing to pick the wrong paths. Doing a lot of damage so that there's not a really high risk there, so I'm not... You know, that might sound like I was a little salty there. Okay, I should have gotten hit there. I'm definitely not salty about it, just kind of... I'm ribbing myself here. Two bombs for three bombs is not really going to be super worth it at this point. Pretty fly. I'll take it. Never not good. Okay. Where are you? Two more, jeez. Just a bunch more money. So happy I didn't lose my save file. Yeah, I was just thinking that, like... okay. Sensor, peace be with you. Huh. I remember unlocking this, but I actually haven't picked this up yet. So not... Ooh, walked right into the creep. That was stupid. So, not only does that now checked off... I think this is an angel item. An angel pool item. But now we get to try and see what it does. No tinted rocks. Mama Gertie. We're not flying, which is a bit of a bummer. But we're doing enough damage that it probably won't matter. Oh. Ah. Had to get me with one. Sure, circle protection is pretty good. I don't think either one of those is super worth it. I might pick them up just to get back into Horror of Babylon, though. Yeah, why not? And then we'll take that. Alright, so we should be back in Horror of Babylon. What is our... Damage is almost maxed out. I'm a little surprised. Okay. Yeah, let's do it. Wow. This is just consumable city. Money equals power would be really great right now. And as I said before, cancer would probably be the trinket I'm looking out for. I know I have curved horn, but where are you? Hey, back here, buddy. But cancer would let me really just pump tears out. Alright, flies. Thank you. Yep, kinda have to. Hanged man. Don't need it for anything. So, circle of protection, if I remember correctly, occasionally damages enemies inside of it. It's not like a Thame or anything like that that guarantees damage. Yeah, I definitely don't want that. But every so often it'll bend bullets back to enemies. So it'll turn them into homing tears. They'll shoot it back at enemies. Which is interesting. Definitely not anything to... really rely on, because it's not, it's, I don't even think it's like 25%, it's probably something more like 10% of the time it'll do it. So it's not a guarantee, but it's kind of nice when it happens. Yeah, it just happened there, even though that happened a little quickly. Okay. Come on. Oh, and it slows down shots that are coming at you too, huh. I don't think I knew that. Still don't know what sensor does. It does, has a little aura effect on it, kind of like, Succubus does. So I'm wondering if it does something similar, if it does the, basically the holy version of whatever that is. So something to keep an eye out for. If I don't figure out what it does during this run, as usual, I will go look it up right after this. And probably go, oh, interesting. Oh, I got hit by something. Yeah, let's just go up. Would have liked to deal with the devil there just to see if there was anything interesting. Still keeping the sun card in hopes that... Whoop, my wife's calling me. 1 second. Alright, I'm back. Let's continue this crazy run here. I was just noticing that it looks like I couldn't pick up... when I picked up two champion belt, looks like it didn't really do anything, which isn't too surprising. Part of the fun of Diplopia is trying to figure out exactly what doubles up and what doesn't. And I think we can safely say champion belt does not. Okay. I like opening up those stone chests because they usually have something pretty great in them. And if they don't, then usually at least you get a couple of consumables for the bomb you tossed in there. I don't know why I'm picking up all of these. For a moment there, I was thinking that I was playing a daily run. It's like, oh yeah, swag points, let's do this. But no. Just doing a regular old run. Nah. That's my thinking noise. This might actually be a secret room, if I can find the right spot. I'm gonna say probably no. Although I can easily try it from here. Nope. Alright, I feel like we're going the right way for the boss. So let's keep heading this way. The algorithm is supposed to be that it's the furthest room from where you started. Well, so it's not this way, but it might be... Oh. That was a pretty dumb position to put myself in. By the by. By the by. So I got exactly what I deserved. Alright. Bosses maybe this way. Forever hopeful. Maybe the boss is here. Getting a lot of sacks all of a sudden. I don't know from what. I didn't think I picked up Sack Boy. What is it, Sack Head? No, I don't think it's that. A sack goes on your head. Oh, that's a dead end. Well, we might as well. While we're here and we have bombs, is this super secret? Nope. Okay, well, I also forgot one of the fundamental laws of the Binding of Isaac algorithm. If there's a big room, you have to go through there at some point. So let's go to the big room. Normally I hate these rooms, because these guys just have so much health. But it's actually not that bad. Okay. You know, I just said, oh, it's not that bad. Take me a little bit longer than I was hoping. That was really close. Mr. Boom is definitely not as good as Guppy's Head. Might as well use two of spades, why not? Still gonna keep the Sun card in the eternal hope that I will get Blind card here at some point. I feel like Sun card is another one I don't see nearly as often as the other ones. Not gonna use the Moon. Go in here though, for sure. Get another Fly. Oh boy. Yeah, let's pick up Experimental Treatment, I guess. Let's get really weird. It'll probably give me a Red Heart container. Excuse me. Now that I'm thinking about it. Yep. Called it. At least it's empty. So I just need to not pick something up. I'm definitely going to play this guy because I have Chaos. Normally he drops, you know, some health or... Thanks. Thanks for breakfasting me. Normally drops health or, like, the box of stuff. But he decided to really stick it to me and drop breakfast. Almost picked up that heart. Alright. Take two. Let's try it. Come on, be better than your brother. Alright. Really? Hilarious. Man, I hate Tower, or Curse of the Tower so much. Just thinking that, sitting here and fuming and thinking, man, go to hell, video game. I don't think those shots are actually hitting him, but it's not hurting me, so can't get too mad about that. Oh, it looks like a couple of them hit there. Woo! Turning out to be a little bit of a shorter run than I was thinking. Usually when I get a chest run or I get a weird run like this, it's gonna take like 50 minutes. I gotta turn this down. That's better. A little too loud in my headphones. Book of Sin is not great. We'll take a second Guppy item, especially get rid of our Red Heart. Yeah, we'll take Goathead, why not? We'll use this. Might as well. Okay. Yeah. Definitely get luck up. Not health up, not health up. Okay, so we gotta make our way back to the beginning to pick up that other Guppy item. It would be pretty fun to pick up a third Guppy item at this point. Actually, I would really like, excuse me. I would actually really like the blank card if I had my druthers. Where is... That's over here. Is this another room exactly like that last one? Double brownie. No. A little bit different here. Alright. Perfect. Yeah, I guess it does also slow down enemies and shots in the... Oh, maybe that's what Sensor does. Hmm. That would be kind of interesting. Not super overpowered, but a nice little bonus. Yeah, and really no other option but to walk on a creep there. Alright, let's pick Sun back up. Pick that back up. Actually, let's pick this up. And pick that up. Give us full health, and then grab that again. There we go. I'm glad I went back in there. All I thought when I first saw it was, really breakfast again? Yeah, Bob's curse is fine. Not gonna hurt us. I was gonna say it gives us closer to the Bob transformation, but I think that's the only Bob item I've seen on this run, so probably not gonna happen. But I think that would mean I'd have to pick up Bob's brain, and I think we all know how I feel about Bob's brain. Is this Guppy? Yup. Great. So our already crazy damage is just crazier. What a fun run. Hot bombs. Let's take it. Just wreck the stain here. There should be another. Yep. You read my mind, Polycephalus. We're definitely not going to pick that up. Alright, I am doing so much damage, I am just going to want... What a hell game. I'm going to try and clear out this whole floor. Bob's brain, ironically enough. Well, I guess it shows up in gold chests a lot, so... Not too surprising. Nothing? Alright. Getting a little spoiled for chests here. Yeah, you're going nowhere. I just had a thought, like, man, this would be a really great run to pick up Dad's key on. And take on Mega Satan. But, well, we still got a couple more rooms. Let's clear out these guys. Excuse me, man. My voice sounded so good earlier today. Then I started recording, and my voice said, hey, how's it? Do you want a bunch of stuff lodged in your throat? How's that sound? Sure. Blood clot, why not? That rhymed. Man, overpowered runs just feel real good. Yeah, let's crack this guy open. Ah, Bomber Boy is fine. More chests, please. Last chance. Come on, Dad's Key. Nope. I think I've already picked this up, but... Just pick it up here for the, for the old item sheet. Okay. Let's head over to the boss and finish this thing up. And this seems to be no problem. And we're done. Alright, thank you very much everyone for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please toss me a like on YouTube. It helps out a ton. Subscribe if you want to see more videos in the future. Leave me a comment. I always love chatting with each and every one of you, and I'll see you next time.